अपार करुणा सिंधु ज्ञानतम शांत रूपिणम श्री चंद्रशेखर गुरु प्रणमामि मुदान्वहम साक्षान मूल प्रमाणाय विष्णोः अमित तेजसे आद्याय सर्वयतीनां चंद्रमौलींद्र ते नमः।
ओम कांचीवासाय विद्महे शांतरूपाय धीमहि तन्नो चंद्रशेखर प्रचोदयात् हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर श्री महापरिव शरणम। Namaskaram, everyone. My name is Amrita Ramaswamy, and I'm based in Edison, New Jersey. We are absolutely honored to present this video on behalf of Sharanalayam Mahapariva and GR Mama. Today, I am really happy to interview a Sharanalayam volunteer, Chakravarti, who is also based in New Jersey. On behalf of the devotees, I'm going to ask a few questions to Chakravarti about Destination Nanganallur, initiators for Destination Nanganallur, namely Likita Jabam. How can devotees do Kainkaryam for Sharanalayam Destination Nanganallur, and finally, the most recent initiative, the Sharanalayam Calendar? I'm sure many of you are kept well informed by Soumyaka and Savita Mami, and of course other volunteers, but this video will be in English for the benefit of non-Tamil speaking devotees. I'm eternally grateful to GR Mama for this opportunity to present this video on his behalf. Now let's dive into the interview. Welcome, Chakravarti. Good to see you yet again in a Sharanalayam video.
Namaskaram, Amrita. Namaskaram, everyone. Thank you, Amrita, for the introduction. I'm absolutely humbled and honored for this opportunity to share some updates on behalf of Sharanalayam Mahapariva and GR Mama. All right. I know you have few questions for me, but if I may, I'm quite intrigued to ask this question to a young devotee, especially like yourself, on what does Mahapariva and GR Mama mean to you? You know, I know that you have met GR Mama, but you may have only heard about Mahapariva from your parents. So please do share your thoughts, Amrita.
Thank you so much, Chakravarti, for the wonderful question. I'm happy to share what they mean to me. Mahapariva is my Ishtadeva, and some have asked me, why do you call him your favorite god when he's a guru? But I don't see him just as a guru. Rather, he is Lord Shiva, an embodiment of Hari, Hara, and Shakti, who came as Adi Shankaracharya to teach us the path of Advaita Vedanta. Although I follow the path of Visishtadvaita, which is laid out by Srimad Ramanujacharya, to me, Mahapariva means the world. Pariva also strongly believes to follow your dharma, whatever it may be. Jiyad Mama is my guru. What Narasimha is meant to Prahalada, Narayana meant to Dhruva, what Rama meant to Hanuman, and Krishna meant to Arjuna, Mahapariva is that to GR Mama. He's a living example to everyone and has shown us that no adversity can be a barrier if our own faith is steadfast. Mama is leading in life per the guidelines laid out by Mahapariva, and he's taking us all together in the divine path that leads us to Mahapariva.
Wow, it's so wonderful to hear from you, Amrita. You beautifully expressed your thoughts. Excellent.
Thank you. So I've heard about Sharanalayam construction at Nangaluru, Chennai. Can you please tell me more about it?
Sure. You know, there have been past videos from Soumyaka and Savita Mami, and they've engaged in such endearing conversations, explaining to us with so much bhakti and shraddha, you know, about Sharanalayam. But I'm happy to share this question that you have to the best of my knowledge for the benefit of non-Tamil speaking devotees. So the construction of Sharanalayam is a divine ordinance from Mahapariva. As you know, Mama converses with Mahapariva during Brahma Muhurtam. So during one such time, Mahapariva mentioned about the construction of Sharanalayam at Nanganallur. So this project is called Destination Nanganallur. And, you know, this is going to be the first of many Sharanalayams coming up. So we do have a Sharanalayam in place at Nanganallur, but this is going to be an extended or a bigger version of Sharanalayam to facilitate large number of devotees to get darshan of Mahapariva. So the first announcement from GR Mama came via Soumyaka and Savita Mami back in September 28th, 2020. That was during the Anusham Day. And subsequently, few initiatives from Mama happened, basically to take collective sankalpam for the construction of a Sharanalayam. So couple of them notably are the Sahasranama Parayanam, that is for chanting Vishnu Sahasranam for 108 days continuously. And then, of course, the Ramanama Likhita Japam, which is the book that was distributed to 2,000 devotees worldwide to write about 2 crore or 20 million count of Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama, right? So Mama says, with implicit faith and melting devotion towards Mahapariva, our sincere prayers are assured to be answered. So the collective prarthana from devotees is nothing short of a penance. So as a result of that, of all our efforts and Mahapariva's anugraham, you must have heard the latest announcement that was shared on December 12, 2021 about the land registration for Sharanalayam. Surprisingly, not so surprising because it's a divine orchestration of Mahapariva that happened to be the 100 days of Sahasranama Parayana. So Soumya Akka and Savita Mami, of course, as always, they will continue to share the updates about the progress. The next thing to happen is Bhumi Puja, and it is expected to happen soon. And you please keep watching for the updates from Sharanalayam.
Of course. I visited the Sharanalayam a couple of years back, but I'm really happy to hear about the expanding of it. Nice. My next question is, how does Mama envision Sharanalayam?
Interesting. Yeah. So before I answer that, let me kind of delve into the meaning of Sharanalayam, which is nothing but a dwelling or abode where we seek shelter, right? So Mama particularly specifies that this is a Shanti Nilayam, where devotees, as part of the Mahapariva Satsangam, gather to seek peace and tranquility, not just for the self, but for the world at large, right? So obviously, Nanganallur is considered as a Punyakshetra. There's a lot of temples, and it's no surprise that Periva chose destination Nanganallur. Mama has shared that Mahapariva feels that a lot of traditions, the ones that have been passed on through generations, have been lost in the due process, and some dharmic practices as well, right? So he feels that those traditions and dharmic practices must be taken to the next generation, particularly somebody like yourself. And Sharanalayam is coming up precisely for that purpose. So now, specific to what Mama's plans or Mahapariva's plans are in terms of how the Sharanalayam is envisioned as. So there's, it's going to be like a multi-story building with the elevators and parking facility and all of that. And the main floor where Mahapariva and the other deities will reside, of course, people who have visited Sharanalayam must be familiar with this. So there'll be a main floor, and then there'll be a concert hall for Satsangam. There'll be a Veda Patashala coming up there, and also a dining hall where devotees partake Mahapariva Prasadam. So by the time this Sharanalayam is constructed, of course, with Mahapariva's divine grace, Mama says that the world would get out of the grip of COVID, right? So that's a big thing. And as we know, Mahapariva has infinite compassion towards us all. And Mama has been executing his divine will in the most faithful and sincere manner.
Amazing. I completely agree with your point on how Mahapariva feels that traditions and overall dharma must be carried on forward by my generation and the upcoming generations too. Very nice. My other question is, you mentioned about Likhita Japam, and there's also a question from everyone on when to submit this. Can you please throw some light on that?
Sure. So the short answer is, the timing is yet to be announced by GR Mama. So as I mentioned earlier, there's been 2,000 people who have received this book worldwide, right? And they're going to write close over about 2 crore or 20 million count of Sri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama. So so the thing is that until the timing is announced, so Mama urges people continue to write, let their family write, and also let the people in their community as well contribute, right? The book goes to a particular family, but we've come across some gracious people who let even the community folks contribute to this penance, right? And then please wait for Sharanalayam, and please hold on to the books. Ideally, keep it in your puja room to maintain its sanctity, and wait for Mama's word, and then mail it back. Okay. So since the books are going to be laid in the foundation at Sharanalayam, and it's going to become one with the infrastructure, right? A place needs to be identified to keep the book safely and maintain its sanctity and divinity, right? So the current Sharanalayam cannot accommodate space for 2,000 books. So the timing is likely going to be when the efforts are kicked off post Bhumi Puja, I think, which is expected to happen in a few months' time with Mahapariva's grace.
Amazing. Also, how can we donate towards the construction of Sharanalayam?
Sure, yeah. This has been a question from a lot of devotees. So as people may be familiar, donations can be made through the website. It's perivaarul.in. You may see the URL flashing in the video. So it's perivaarul.in. So basically, there are two trust accounts. One for donations for the Sri Mahaparivar Arul Trust, which is called SMART, where there's a lot of initiatives that Mama takes care of, which include temple renovation, Go Samrakshana, Veda Samrakshana, and helping the needy with education or marriage, medical expense, and so on, right? And then there is another trust account by the name Mahapariva Arul Trust Sharanalayam. This is where the devotees can transfer their yat kinchat, right? So as you may be seeing in the screen here, so the name of the trust is Sri Mahapariva Arul Trust Sharanalayam. The bank is City Union Bank. The branch is Mylapore. IFSC code is CIUB 0000279. It's a savings bank account. The account number is 500101027254. So there are two ways that you can transfer this. One is you can add this account detail to your beneficiary list in the bank and then transfer. And then you can also go and fill a form with the details. Again, you will see that link in the video description below. And then there's the other way to do it is, as I mentioned, going to perivaarul.in website, you would see a donate button. As you see in the screen, you'd see a donate button on the top right. You click on it, and then you go to a page where it shows the two options that I mentioned. One is donations for Mahapariva Sharanalayam at Nanganallur, and the other one is the Smart Trust. The Smart Trust is upcoming now. So your question was specific to donation for Sharanalayam. So there is a donate button there, which you can click. And then it takes you to a page where it asks you for donor name, email, mobile number, PAN number, your address. You can fill the amount that you'd like to donate, accept the terms and conditions, and pay now. And it takes you to a page where you can make the payment. All right. So these are the two ways to donate to the Sharanalayam construction. But here's an important point to note, though. So this particular thing that I explained, right now, the donation is only possible for India residents. It's not yet open for overseas residents. So the overseas residents cannot contribute. So that is primarily because of the Foreign Contributions Regulation Act. And the Sharanalayam cannot accept contributions yet because we're not registered yet. So for that, the trust has to complete 3 years of existence. And in due course, in the coming months, this would happen, and overseas devotees will be able to contribute as well, right? So this is primarily, see, Mama has a clear distinction, and he emphasizes on three things, right? There should be no violation of law, no breach of trust, and no evasion of tax. So he wants to make sure that all of this happens as per law, as per the tax provisions. So that is why it is currently open only for India residents. And in the near future, when the registration is done, it will be overseas. For overseas residents, it will be open. But then again, here is another option that the overseas devotees can think about. You may be sending money to your near and dear in India, right? So you can send money on behalf of, for the purpose of Sharanalayam temple construction, and they can contribute on your behalf. So that's probably a way that you can, for overseas devotees, can contribute, at least for now, until the FCRA registration is complete.
You've shared some very valuable information. Thank you. Also, like last year, I understand we are coming up with a Sharanalayam calendar, this time around as well for 2022. Can you please share some details for the benefit of the devotees?
Sure, yeah. So, you know, we might have seen Savita Mami's video. I think it was on December 21st, 2021. So again, you would find the links for registering in the YouTube video description, right? So there are two options, one for registration of India-based devotees, and the other link is for the overseas devotees. So right now, in the perivarul.in homepage, India devotees can directly register and pay, right? But this option, however, is not yet open for the overseas devotees as yet. And the reason for that is, as of now, we're just gathering the order quantity, and then subsequently we'll streamline the delivery. So the registration confirmation also, this is something that the devotees have been asking, that I have not received any confirmation. So the registration confirmation will eventually be provided at a later date, right? The other question I've come across is the cost of the calendar. Again, that is something that is work in progress. As I mentioned earlier, the order quantity has to be estimated, and then we have to determine the cost, factoring in the courier charges specific to each geography location, right? So once the calendar is printed and ready, a single point of contact will be assigned to each geography, each location, who will receive the calendars, and they'll distribute it to the devotees. So this is slated to happen in the due course of a few weeks. So until then, let's stay tuned for updates from Sharanalayam. Oh, and I also remember that there's also a question about, can we see a sample of the calendar? So once it is printed, of course, we will be happy to show you a sample. But for now, you can see a snapshot of the Jan month in the Perivarul homepage, perivarul.in homepage. All right. I hope that answers your questions.
Yeah, of course. All right, then. Thank you for answering all my questions on behalf of Sharanalayam and Jeer Mama Chakravarti. To summarize, we covered topics about Sharanalayam, Destination Nanganallur, Likhita Japam updates, how to donate for Sharanalayam construction, and lastly, about the calendar registration and distribution. I hope everyone would find this useful. Once again, many thanks to Jeer Mama for giving us this opportunity to share these updates. Hara Hara Shankara, Jai Jai Shankara, Sri Mahaperiva Sharanam.